Alright, so I was gonna go to the gym. I was very impressed with especially the equations that most of you wrote, so very good. There's this gym and you could be either a member or a non-member. Members, let's see, they only pay $5 an hour, but they have to pay $80 one time, right? So they have to pay $80 plus $5 per hour. Non-members do not have to pay the $80. This would be, sometimes gyms will have this where you can just pay to use it for a day or something because you're out of town, something like that. So this is just $13 an hour. Right. So I kind of organize the stuff in a little table. So for the number of hours Chloe will use the gym this week, maybe she's out of town for a week-long conference or something like that. Chloe's very serious about her gym going. Looks into it and she says, it turns out for the amount of hours that she's going to use the gym, it doesn't matter if she pays the membership fee and gets the cheaper hourly rate or if she just goes in as a non-member and pays the hourly rate, and we're supposed to find how many hours she plans to use the gym this week. So the first part, I don't want you to just, you know, guess. I don't want you to just figure it out. We're practicing writing equations, right? So what equation can we write to represent this situation?
13x equals 80 plus 5x.
Can you explain that equation to us, Blake?
Well, x is represented as how many hours she's going.
Okay, x is hours. Yeah?
And then the number next to it is how much it is per hour.
So you go 2 hours, and how many cost you? 5 times 2, which is $10. 3 hours, 5 times 3, which is $15, and so on. Okay? There's more to it, right? There's other parts to it.
Yeah, and then 80 is how much you have to pay.
Just an extra $80, just slap that on, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then over here, we got the same kind of a thing. No additional charge, just number of hours times $13. Okay, now it just is down to solving this equation. Which, how would we do that? First, reason for that is right here. Here's the secret sauce. This is why we're doing this. Because 5x minus 5x is?
Zero.
And we get no x's on that side. We only have x's on the other side and numbers on the opposite side. So that's clear. 13x minus 5x is 8x. So this is kind of saying, like, if she used the gym that cost $8 an hour, got to $80, that's how many hours it would be if she were to, it were to cost the same for either way. So we solve this by doing what? It's almost always the last step in solving these equations. Monica?
Divide 8
by each side. 8 on both sides, and 10 hours is how many hours she's going to use the gym this week, or she plans to use the gym this week. Okay. Questions? Comments? Okay, here's a really common thing that might be in an equation, like a first step that we might do. What am I talking about?
Distribute.
Distribute that 5, 2x, where x is the y. 5 equals 5x, what?
Minus 20.
Very good. Sometimes we forget to distribute the 5 to the negative 4, and it just stays a negative 4. Careful about that. Next. Jack, ready?
Minus 5 on both sides.
Minus 5, okay, so I subtract 5 from this side. Can I say 2x minus 5?
No.
Can I do 5 minus 5?
Yeah.
5 minus 5 is?
0.
0, of course, so we get 2x on this side. Subtract 5 on this side, can I subtract 5 from the 5x?
No.
So I subtract the 5 from the negative 20? Yeah, so they are the same thing. So we have 5x still on this side, minus 25.
Subtract 2x from each side.
Subtract 2x. Okay, 2x minus 2x?
Zero.
0 equals 5x minus 2x?
3x.
Comes positive. Minus 25? Okay, now what?
Doesn't work.
Doesn't work? This is still true. You can always do anything you want to an equation as long as what?
It's balanced.
Do it to both sides. So this is still true. It should still work. We're not done, right? Johnny?
You would add 25 to both sides.
Yeah, we can still work this equation. We don't have to back up, but we certainly could. Right? We already did what we did. We might as well just keep going. It's not that terrible looking. 3x equals 25. Grady?
Divided by 3 on both sides.
Nice. I don't know if any of you gave me the answer 25 over 3. Don't be afraid to give me an answer that is a fraction. It's exactly correct. I don't think anybody lost credit because you also, what was it?
8.3.
You, I think all of you, unless I'm mistaken, put that little line over there, which means repeating forever. And if we understand that there's an infinite number of 3s, then they are exactly the same. If you were to give me 8.3, I would mark it wrong. Like 1 point out of 5, so you got 4 out of 5 for that. Because this is not the same as this. This is not the same as this. This is the answer, 25 divided by 3. So just a word of caution there. Don't be afraid of fractions. Fractions are a perfectly good thing, just a fine answer. Leave it like that. This is also exactly the same thing. Okay? That's that. Any questions? All right. So that kind of wraps up. Let me just write it down here. Let's see, 1.3. So combining like terms is all under the big umbrella of solving equations, right? Combining like terms first, before we start solving the equation, you know, using strategies we've already had, variables on both sides. Distributing, puts it all together. Having variables on both sides, distributing before you begin, adding like terms before you begin. So as we move on, here is the deal. I want you to write an equation for the perimeter of this rectangle. Equation for the perimeter of the rectangle. Does somebody have an equation for the perimeter for us, Alex?
6 plus x squared equals y.
Okay, so why 6?
Because 3, and the other side plus 3 equals 6.
Okay, so this side is 3, this side is 3. Remember, the perimeter is, you measure the length all the way around. Okay, so 3 plus 3 is 6.
And then there, and then the other side is an x as well, so it's 2 x's, so it's x squared.
What do I do with, when I have this x, and this x, what do I do with the two x's?
Add them.
Add them. X plus x. Now, what does x squared mean?
X times.
It means x
times
x.
Oh, okay, yeah.
So it's x plus x.
2x.
Okay, so we'll just.
Sorry.
There we go. And you said it equals y. Where did y come from?
Just a variable I thought of.
Just a variable you thought of. Why did you feel like you needed to think of a variable?
I don't know.
It
just
kind of
came to me, yes.
You know, you didn't set it equal to a number. You didn't set it equal to x. You set it equal to a different variable. Sean?
Because we've already used x, so.
Oh, yeah.
what do we need this other variable for? What's it all about, Johnny?
We don't know what the perimeter is.
We don't know what the perimeter is. The perimeter is a different thing. It's not x, so it needs to be something different. It can't be x. So we call it anything else. Anything we want. Y works perfectly fine. Anybody else use anything else?
I use the P.
P for perimeter? P as well? Okay. P for perimeter. That probably would have you go with. But Y is also like, when we need a second variable, Y is a pretty popular choice. Either way you go, it works fine. Alex was the first one to raise his hand, so we're going to use Y. Okay. So X plus 6 plus 2X equals Y. Okay, so now what I want you to do is I'm going to tell you several times over what the perimeter is. I want you to tell me something. So maybe I'll should. I'm going to tell you that the perimeter, which is y, is 24. I want you to tell me how long this side is. Okay. So you got an equation. Solve that equation for x. Okay, Okay, I'm going to give you another one. I'm just the same thing. I'm going to tell you that the perimeter is 40. Again, I want you to use the equation. I don't want you to just like say, oh, I know what x would have to be, because we're algebraists. We're going to solve using an equation, get that practice. Okay, so using that equation, tell me what is x if the perimeter is 40. Okay, one last time. I'm going to tell you that the y is 124. And tell me what x is. All right. Just from a quick scan around the room, it seems like, unless I'm wrong, you'd stop me. It seems like we all got 9, 17, and 59.
And if you didn't, it looks like we fixed that mistake.
Okay. Now, how many of you, when I told you that y is 124, for the third time, you did something like this? 6 plus 2x equals 124. Did you do that? Okay. And then you subtracted 6. Subtracted 6. 2x equals 118.
Yeah.
Divide by 2. X equals
59.
Yeah. Not too difficult, right? But this was that very similar to what you did for the previous perimeter?
Yeah.
In the previous perimeter? Every time you plug in a different perimeter, you had to do the same steps to solve for x. A little bit tedious, right? A little bit. I tried to make it not too tedious. But we're doing the same thing. Like, if you're going to keep telling perimeter, I'm going to keep doing the same steps, right? Subtract 6, divide by 2, subtract 6, divide by 2. I'm going to keep doing that, right? So why don't we rewrite this formula so that instead of equaling y, the perimeter being the thing that I keep giving you, right? Instead of that, it equals the thing that you're looking for. Right? Looking for x over and over and over. Can we take this equation? I'm sorry, 6 plus 2x. Can we take this equation and rewrite it? So now x is the thing that is, you know, equals. Like if I told you x, it would be, I'd just do all the math on the left side and you know the perimeter, right? Can we rewrite it, Grady?
Would it be 6 plus y equals 2x?
You just swap it?
Yeah.
Well, whatever it looks like, it should reflect the work that we've just done three times in a row, right?
Or 6 minus y equals 2x.
Let's solve for x in this equation and pretend like y is a number. Well, y is a number, isn't it? Pretend like we know what y is. Like if that were our situation, what would we do? If I plug the number in here, let's just not plug a number in there, what would I do to solve for x? Josie?
Y minus 6 divided by 2.
Let's subtract 6, right? That's what we would, that would be the first thing that we did if we were trying to solve for x. Yes, 2x equals y minus 6, right? It just stays y minus 6, because what can I do?
Nothing.
Nothing I can do. I can't combine them. What do I do now? Great.
You divide by 2.
You would divide by 2, just like we did over and over and over. You did it three times, right? You divide by 2 at the end. So we got x equals y minus 6 divided by 2. Mm. So now we have an equation where we don't have to subtract 6 and divide by 2 every time I want to figure out what x is. Okay. This is what you might call rewriting an equation. Or since there's multiple variables, sometimes we call that a formula. You can call it that. Your book calls it solving a literal equation. Okay? Think about that word literal for a second. I like to think about words. Where else do you hear like liter? Like that beginning liter. What are other words that have that in them?
Literally.
Literally? Other words? Where does it start? It's literally, literal. Literal.
Okay, the word literal.
How about, what do you, what's that?
Literature.
What's literature? What's that? Well, you read literature, right? So literature is actually the writing, right? And what's in writing? Words, and what are words made of?
Letters.
Letters. Letters. Litter. Okay, very close to each other. No coincidence there. So literature, literacy, right? What's literacy? Word literacy?
No.
Literate?
Oh, I've heard of another word. Illiterate?
Illiterate, literate, illiterate. What does illiterate mean? No, not quite. I mean, there's a specific thing that you're not able to do. That thing is?
Read or write.
Read or write, yes. You're illiterate, you can't read or write. You're literate, you can read and write. Okay? So this literal is referring to letters in the equation. This equation has multiple letters. We're able to solve for any chosen letter that we want to solve for. We're solving a literal equation. Okay? So when an equation has multiple letters, not just x, not just y, but x and y, or c and f, or b and h. We can solve, if you tell me which one to solve for, I'll solve for it. See what I'm saying? That's the skill we're practicing today. Okay? So, if I said 2b plus r equals h, these are completely made up letters, they mean nothing. Okay, B doesn't stand for base, H doesn't stand for height, R doesn't stand for radius. I just made up some letters. Okay. Could you solve for B? Did you get B by itself? Just give it a shot. Give everybody a chance to do it on their own, and I'll ask you in a few seconds.
Subtract R from each side.
Okay, Charlie says subtract R from both sides. 2B equals, what does the right side look like now?
H minus R.
H minus R. Charlie, take it.
You're going to subtract 2 from each side.
Subtract 2?
Or divide by 2.
Divide by 2. Cool. 2 divided by 2 is 1, 1h, no, 1b. Divide by 2 over here, b equals h minus r over 2. And did we solve for b?
Yep.
B is by itself. It is solved for Alex.
I was just wondering. I did it a little differently, but I got the same answer. I took, I divided 2b, I divided 2.
Divide by 2. Ooh, we're getting some tricky territory. This is something we could do first. I'm just gonna wonder if maybe by a happy accident you came to the same thing because you made multiple math errors.
Maybe.
It's a very, very common thing to do, but what would it look like if I divide by 2 first? Okay, so let me come over here and see what you got. So you have divide by 2 and divide by 2. First, that's the first mistake. Okay. Now 2b divided by 2 is b, correct?
Yeah.
But do you see, let's look at the right side. What am I doing to the right side?
Dividing by 2.
Dividing by 2. Look at the left side. Am I dividing the left side by 2?
No.
No, I'm dividing just part of the left side by 2. I divide everything by 2. Okay? Now that we've done that, we can still do this correctly. We will come out with the right answer. We'll have the same answer as this other one. We just are going to have a little more work than I think we realized. But 2b divided by 2 is b. What's r divided by 2?
R divided by 2.
R is just r over 2. You can do about it. H over 2. That's all you can do there. All right, now, this is kind of nice because b doesn't have a 2 on it. We have the dividing by 2 taken care of. What would we do next? Johnny?
Minus r over 2 on both sides.
Subtract that guy. Subtract r over 2 on this side. So what's h over 2 minus r over 2?
R minus
h minus r
over 2.
Yeah, we can do that, right? Because both of these fractions have
common denominator,
right? And if that was 5 over 2 minus 3 over 2, you would just do 5 minus 3, which is 2 over 2, right? Whatever h and r are, you would subtract them, and it would be over 2 because they have that common denominator. So they're the same. You got the same answer, right? But sometimes we get the same answer by happy accident because we made multiple math errors. We want to be careful about that. Okay? Let's try this one. 2 times. Let's say x plus y minus 5 equals q. All right, let's solve for y.
So you distribute the 2 to the x and the y.
I want a distribution, it's beautiful property. 5 equals cube, okay?
And then I took, you take plus 5 on each side.
Alright, and I'll have somebody else pick it up here, we're solving for y, remember? So wait, so what's on the right side, just real quick?
Cube plus 5.
Cube plus 5, okay. Cube plus 5. Okay, Johnny?
Minus
2x
from the sides.
Okay, 2x minus 2x is 0, right?
Yep.
Seems mm-hmm. good. Subtract 2x from the sides. Seems good. 2y equals q plus 5 equals 2x. All right.
And then divide both sides by
2. Divide both sides by 2, right? It's such a common last thing to do, right? Divide by whatever to get the thing, whatever it is, by itself. So y equals q. 5 minus 2x, you get all of that, and you divide it by 2. Great?
I have a question on that.
Mm-hmm.
I think I did this wrong, but on the third step, or the, yeah, that right there, I just divide by 2, like, for both of them.
Okay, so you divide, let me move that over, and let's cross over to Grady's reality, where we instead divide by 2. Now, your answer may even look different than this, but be equivalent. So let's just make sure that we do it correctly and agree here. So we got 2x plus 2y equals q plus 5. Yes, okay. So you divide by 2.
Mm-hmm.
Now, as long as we talked about this possible mistake on the last one, if you divide by whatever, make sure you divide by whatever on both sides completely. Everything gets divided by 2. Every term gets divided by 2. So we divide everything by 2. All right, 2x divided by 2 is?
1x.
1x. 2x, 2y divided by 2 is?
Y.
1y. Q plus 5 divided by 2, we're just going to leave it as q plus 5 divided by 2. I could write it as q divided by 2 plus 5 divided by 2, but who, why? Why would I do that?
I did minus x on both sides.
Minus x, minus x. I can only see one problem, one common problem here, and that would be that you subtract, subtract x from the... Yeah. See, the thing about these two things is this has a denominator of 2? Is this has a denominator of?
Nothing.
One. Right? So I would need to make it have a common denominator. If I wanted to put those two things together, I could leave it like this. That would be fine. Right? Just subtract x. Or give it a denominator of 2. It has a denominator of 1, so I multiply the numerator and denominator by 2. And now I have a common denominator and I can put them together. Y equals q. Plus 5 minus 2x over 2, just like this. Same thing. But q plus 5 over 2 minus x is also correct. If they would give you, if I gave you x and you put it in here and you put it over here before we combined, like terms, I guess like if you put it, the x right there and q, you have to know q. If you plug them both into here or you plug them here, you get the exact same answer, right, every single time. Okay, we've got some time. I feel like you guys are ready to practice on your own, see how you're doing. So if you get started on that homework, if you did already do your homework, maybe you should just go read back through and recheck it that you got everything going right. Because if you learned anything new today, maybe you made some mistakes that we talked about today, Josie.
You want us to do the 1.3 as well for Wednesday?
We already did that.
Oh, we did.
Just handed that back. So this is for today.